Everyone, this is Kieran. Today's exercise is looking at progressing the peroneal longus exercise into something with a little more load. So if you're not sure what we're talking about, look at the part one video of this where we talk about beginning to rehab some of the muscles on the outside of the ankle. It's important to do after ankle sprains, especially these lateral ankle sprains, but it's also important to do after any sort of calf injury or any lower leg injury anyway. So it's kind of a staple in most ankle rehab programs. In the first video, we talked about introducing load to this muscle in a more low load environment. And so by doing that, we're doing open kinetic chain, and we're also using just a rubber band where that tension is maximal only at end range. Eventually though, we need to progress to some heavier situations, because without that heavy load, we're not gonna see the majority of that muscle being recruited. And that's really important for the function of any muscle, especially when that task that you're doing day to day requires that level of recruitment. And that's only gonna come from doing things fast or doing things heavy. So calf raises are a good option. If we look at some of the articles around this, the calf raise position can change how much this muscle is activated. And it's not to say that you should always calf raise this way. We've got some other videos focusing on just the specific calf raise exercise. This is more of the bias towards the peroneal longus. So if you've had a peroneal longus injury, confirmed either by imaging or with muscle testing, or I guess a bit of palpation as well, depending on tenderness with muscle trigger points, if they exist. Anyway, so this is just to focus on trying to get that peroneal longus activation. Basically, the position of turning the leg out is gonna create more of that. So we're talking about doing a calf raise with the leg turned out versus straight versus turned in. And basically when you turn the foot in, that's the least amount. This is sort of middle. And then, well, it's definitely way more than this. And then going out here is a little bit more. And the research said that this to this was a significant difference. But, you know, proportionally as far as the EMG recruitment, I mean, we're, you know, is it clinically significant? That's a bit of a different conversation. But if you want maximum activation of this peroneal longus muscle on the outside, we want to have foot turned out. So, and part of that is because it encourages some of this eversion. So when I'm standing here, I'm gonna do the calf raise with this foot turned out. So we're doing right leg. And if I turn around, and this is me going straight versus if I turn out that way, and now I come up and down, now I'm getting more and more activation through here. And part of that is, well, you could rationalize that part of it is because of that big toe attachment. We go through some of the anatomy in the first video, so double check that again if you want to get some more information. But basically this muscle comes down the side, it goes under the foot, and it wraps over to that first metatarsal down the end, that distal end, and it helps push the big toe down. And so by being on the outside here, you really have to push through the big toe. So it encourages that muscle to really to be used to push you up. So if that feels like that ends up being quite easy, then you could start holding like a dumbbell or a kettlebell on the same side arm. So if I'm doing the right leg, put the weight in the right hand and load yourself up till it's about the same ability as the non-injured side. Yeah, so have a go at those and see how you get on. If you like this video, then please hit like below. Otherwise, to check out more of our content in the future, you can subscribe to our channel by clicking our logo over here. And to check out our latest video, click up here.